E.Jones Show.
Welcome back to the E.Jones Show.
The E.Jones Show.
Featuring Sharonda and Thalys.
Plus
DJ Mark. NYC.
Yeah, you already know what it is. It's the E.Jones Show with your man E.Jones on the helm. Featuring your girl Sharonda, Thalys, DJ Mark with the lunchtime mix, and of course, DJ Mark and my man Soul Man. Another episode of the E.Jones Show in full effect, man. How are y'all doing? We got special guests and things like that. So it's going to be a very, very exciting show. When I say exciting, I mean exciting. We have the legendary group, or some group members from the legendary group, Klymaxx, joining us today. And I'm definitely excited about that. And I'm talking to Miss Joyce Irby. How are you doing?
I'm doing good. I'm just, you know, enjoying 99 degrees every day in the A. Not really.
You got to rub that in, right? Because I'm in PA, so you're going to say what you enjoying. Okay. Go ahead. I'm listening.
Listen, man, you're doing a lot better off than we are. It's like it's just too much heat. It's too much heat.
Well, I can deal with the heat. I'd rather deal with the heat than the cold.
Yeah, but seasons are nice.
Yeah, true. I guess I got one up on you. So, you know, we got a lot of questions. We got a lot of conversation to have with you. So, first and foremost, I'll reintroduce you again. We are talking to the legendary Miss Joyce Irby from Klymaxx. And we're honored to have you come on and grant us with this interview. So, thank you. I am Eric E. Jones.
Oh, I wondered what the E was for. All right, Eric E.
Whatever one you want to call me, you can go with Eric or you can go with E. I'm over here smiling because I grew up to y'all music. So I'm smiling right now.
That's a beautiful thing. I get so many comments online from young people. And what's funny is they'll say, you know, I had to listen to you guys when I was younger, like in high school or a teenager or even like in elementary school. And then they connect on a different level and they say, but when you did that Dougie Fresh record, It was like, then I like became a fan because, you know, I was always a little more hip hop. So I'm just grateful that people just remember, you know, that people just remember the music, period.
Well, people's always going to remember good music over bad music. So you guys put out nothing but good music. And even the joints you did with Dougie Fresh was good. So it's a blessing.
It is. It's a, you know, it's a blessing to create things that people like to hear. It's like we're both blessed. It's like giving and receiving love. Or like when we're doing a concert, it's like it feels so good for to give people music that's healing. But then we get a healing in return because they love it so much. It's just like a love circle, and I just love it. Like doing live stuff is the best. I just love it.
So we're going to go back a little bit. We're not going to go too far back. But we're going to go back a little bit. When did you, as an individual, discover I wanted to sing, I wanted to be in the industry? When did it hit you?
Oh, man, maybe when I was, all I can tell you is that by 12, I was playing guitar and driving my parents crazy.
Mm-hmm.
And I was playing saxophone in the high school band, and I was playing trumpet, and playing bass in the garage with kids in my neighborhood. I still get Facebook messages from middle and high school people talking about me playing bass in the garage and how they remember. So, you know, just always, and I stood on the loading dock and would play my bass with no amp for every concert, Earth, Wind & Fire, Ohio Players, Parliament, Funkadelic, Patti LaBelle, when she was with LaBelle, everybody. And, you know, George Clinton just took a liking to me and just let me follow him around. And he just, like, you know, mentored me. And it's funny, we're still great friends. I just saw him a few weeks ago. We are still the best of friends since I was like 16.
Oh, wow. Wow. That's a friendship.
Oh, yeah, that's my boo. And he has stood up for me and gotten fights with people about me, and he felt like they were being unfair to my reputation, all this kind of stuff. It's just been amazing. And I've just been blessed knowing some incredible people.
Definitely.
Yeah.
So now let's move forward. The all-girl band originated in Los Angeles. An all-girl band. You didn't feel like this was going to be like, wow, kind of catty? How did this mesh?
I had no clue, because I had always played with guys that were like sort of like jazz musicians. And actually, I charted as a rapper at Fenderella in November of 1980 with a song called A Wild and Crazy Song that Frankie Crocker loved. It was on TK Records out of Miami, Casey and the Sunshine Band label.
Mm-hmm.
And the record was out for like 3 weeks, and it got to like nationally, like maybe 78. I still have the Cashbox magazine that I bought at the time.
Mm-hmm.
And then I wouldn't sign with TK, and they pulled the record. And then a few months later, I was in L.A. And, oh, also one thing. I have Lorena Stewart, who was living in Los Angeles, and she sings Meeting in the Ladies Room and Divas Need Love, too.
Okay.
And I'm going to send her a text with this number, if you'd like for her just to call in and say hello.
Why not? You know, the door is open now. I let you in, so I might as well let anybody else in.
About everybody, but I know she is available. Oh, that's funny.
definitely.
But listen, talk about being catty. While I'm texting her, I will say I just finished writing a memoir called I'd Still Say Yes.
Okay.
Which was suggested to me by one of the producers of Unsung, because this is the third Unsung I was a guest on talking about people. And she was like, Miss Joyce, you need to write your life story and call it I'd Still Say Yes. And I thought, that's funny. And then I took about 4 months and did it. And it's just, my life has been so amazing. Not having anything to do with me, but just, it's like the divine has given me opportunities to meet so many incredible people. And
Amen.
A lot of people don't, you know, back in the day, we didn't have the internet and stuff like that. So you had to go through a gatekeeper, to get in the music business.
Uh-huh.
And we were lucky enough to have Dick Griffey keep taking chances on us.
Got you.
And I can't thank him enough. You know, we had some wild and crazy, crazy, crazy times in that group.
I can only imagine a female band. Wow.
Oh, my gosh.
Wow. I can imagine. We're going to touch on them stories. I'm trying to get as much in there as I can get. So, I miss you. Do you know, because I'm going to reveal the age. I'm 50. Do you know?
Ooh.
Do you know? I think you know where I'm about to go with this. Do you know how many people probably came up on you and said, you know, I got pregnant off that song?
I get more of the song meant so much to me at this time because I was going through a breakup or I was just reuniting with somebody.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like I could feel that you were feeling what I was feeling, or I could relate to how you sang it. Man, that is so priceless to me. Even today, I go on YouTube, and it's all these years later, and people still
talking about it.
So, yeah, and it just makes me, I mean, some of them, and I'll hit them back, and I'm like, this is why I sing. I'm like, thank you. Your comments are priceless. It makes me feel like I'm doing my job, and I'm so grateful.
Well, I got a story to tell you for that one. I miss you. I was in South Bronx Job Corps, and we had a game room with a jukebox. So I didn't know this young lady liked me at all. Plus, I never paid her no attention anyway.
Mm-hmm.
So, with that being said, you know, she said, "You know what? I want to get his attention. I want to get his attention. I want to get his attention." And I'm saying to myself, you know, she's telling her friend that. But I'm still like, she ain't talking to me, so I ain't worrying about it. She puts on I Miss You. And as I was walking, trying to go out the door, she's standing in front of the door singing the song. I was like, but I ain't going nowhere. And that was my story for the song.
Beautiful. Man, that's beautiful. And I just recut I Miss You because I thought I could sing it better and put more feeling in it. And it's the same, but it's different just because I just feel a little more intense about it. But I'm so grateful. And Lynn Maltby, our piano player, wrote the song about, you know, a relationship that she had that didn't go as well as she wanted it to. But I'm so grateful I got to sing the song.
Oh, God, I can't wait to hear that. And we have somebody else that called in. Could you tell us your name?
This is Lorena Love Stewart.
Hey, Lorena, how you doing?
Hey, Lorena. Hey, Kitty. Hi, how's everyone doing?
Everything is good. Everything is good.
We're having a meeting in the ladies' room.
With one man. Hold on. Don't.
With one man.
With one man. So what part do you play in this story? Like, are you part of Klymaxx?
Yes.
Okay.
I've been with Klymaxx from day one. I am the original lead vocalist of the group. I sang Beating in the Ladies' Room, Divas Need Love to Sexy, and on and on and on.
Okay, so now I'm going to go.
Was in L.A.
I'm going to go to the master question because I'm hearing there's two Klymaxxes.
Well,
there might be three, four, or five.
So I'm going to give you ladies the floor and let y'all go with it. I'm going to give y'all the floor and let y'all tell the audience what is going on.
I'll start, and Lorena, you can come in and finish. We all, like, went our separate ways. And then at some point, I wanted to play and contacted everybody. I guess nobody wanted to initially. And then Cheryl Cooley said, I want to. So I was like, okay, then we'll work together. And so I was like, I was living in Atlanta, so I was like, I'll get plane tickets, I'll buy them in advance. I'll come out here like every other week and we'll rehearse and we'll do some stuff. So I guess a month went by and then I called Cheryl and she was like crying on the phone. Oh, well, I don't know. I can't get anybody, so we can't do it. Okay, I was crushed. So I went back to Atlanta and I was like, I started talking to some people, Lorena, a couple other girls that we played with. The next thing I know, Cheryl Cooley is doing gigs as Klymaxx with nobody in her group that ever sang on a Klymaxx record. She's playing a guitar and booking gigs as Klymaxx.
Wow.
And so that right there, and then she did that first, and then she tried to copyright the name so none of us could use it for her fake band. And there's been a rift, even with the rest of us who don't get along half the time. We will all speak to each other, but nobody will deal with Cheryl Cooley.
Oh,
nobody.
Yes, this is true.
Wow.
This is true. Yeah, so, yeah, it happened, but we were able to put a stop to it. So, as it should be, all original six members, if they choose to form their own version of a Klymaxx band, we all have the right to use the name in some way, form or fashion, not just one person. So that's the beauty of it all, I guess.
Yeah, that's the beauty and sort of the sadness of it all, because for a while, me, Lorena, and Bernadette still worked together with some supplementary players who'd been playing with us anyway, because Bern had stopped playing drums, so we had another girl playing drums, and Robin, our keyboard player, had disappeared like 20 years ago, so we had another keyboard player. So we were still, and even Lynn was with us for a while, so we were still, the rest of us, trying to work together. And that worked for a while, and then I guess Bern decided she just wanted to do her solo thing. She wanted to try something different, because she's really a creative genius and very theatrical. And she wanted to try her own thing, and that was about 5 years ago, and she said, I'm moving on, and so she moved on. And, you know, Lorena and I worked together for, you know, off and on, and it's just, I just got to keep singing while I got my voice. This is all I've ever wanted to do. And I tell people up front, even like on my Facebook page, I don't say this is the original Klymaxx. I'm like, this is my reboot, you know. And fans would love if we could all work together. But I can't control what other people do. I just got to keep singing. Lorene, I'll hand it off to you too. Like, you know.
And, well, I'm a, I guess, semi-retired. I'll never say retired because, you know, the music is in me. It has been from a child. But as far as the touring, I would say I'm semi-retired. I'm one of those that believes in never say never. You know, you never know what could happen. Like Joyce was saying, we know that the fans would love to see, you know, all originals, but, you know, that's a tall leap of faith, but I've just learned to never say never. We may be in our wheelchairs rolling rolling on the stage, and maybe by that time we've put everything aside and say, well, this is it. We'll all just go together.
You never know. Yeah, never say never. We seen groups that said, we ain't never performing together. And then a couple of days later, let's get the band back together, baby.
Yeah, but that's guys. And when it comes to business, guys are like, let's just do the business and handle it. But for some reason, we have all these other psychological frictions, which are just, you know, in the way. It's just who we are. And it's unfortunate. From a fan standpoint, but I will say I'm so grateful that I had the opportunity to work with this group of women, because I feel like we were unique and we all contributed something that was different and valuable, and that was just so cool, you know?
Definitely. Y'all was trendsetters, definitely. I have to admit that. Icons and legends, because when we say Klymaxx, we have to put y'all in a legendary status, because if people don't see you guys as legends, then maybe they bumped their head a little bit too hard. But you guys are also, you ladies, you queens are also legends.
That's beautiful, Eric. Thank you. That's beautiful.
I'm a big fan of music, and now I can write this off, because when Joe said, I can get you Joyce from Klymaxx and the other couple of members, I was like, yo, stop playing with me, man. Don't play with me.
I like Joe. He feels a cool dude. Hey, Joe. He's so funny.
Shout out to Joe. And he was like, Eric, I got you. Watch this. And then he made it happen. Because I wanted to hear you guys' story. I hate hearing somebody else telling a story or what you read on the internet or any of the above. I wanted to hear what you guys had to say. And I'm glad. And I'm blessed that you guys put it all on the table. But now, let's talk about what's going on now. Let's leave the cloud alone, and let's talk about now. Like, what's going on?
The cloud. Well, for me, I can just say, I got to keep singing. It's like somebody told me when I was like 30 that I was too old to sing. I was like, okay, so I just started signing songwriters and producers and working with kids, you know, find Lloyd and
Sammie,
Dallas, yeah, all of them. And so I spent another 20 years just facilitating other people, and I was like, but I really want to sing. And I still have my voice, so that's just a love that I have. And even if I do it once a year or 50 times a year, I'm so grateful for every time I get a chance to step out on a stage and sing something. And I'm back into like writing and recording too, because I'm like, why stop if everything is still working? And ladies, here's some advice. Love yourself, love your body, keep your body moving, and it don't stop until you let it. Keep everything moving and do stuff.
That's right. Keep it moving and eat healthy.
I like that. She just came out of nowhere. She was like, that's right. Keep it healthy and keep it moving. You heard that, ladies, right? And I'm going to say something for the men. Keep it healthy. Keep it moving. Don't just sit around and wither away.
But men generally seem to do more. It's like women, we're just like, well, man, forget all of that. You got one body. use it. Use it.
Yes.
You know?
So with, are you guys coming, you know, into like Philly or New York or like any show dates coming this way?
Not at this time. I mean, I myself, you know, am working on it. It's just, I realized something, and older artists should all take note of this, and fans of artists. It's like people who do shows rely on data. And they look at so much data, and a lot of older people aren't as active on social media, like on Spotify and Pandora and liking things and Instagram and all this other stuff. It's like it takes them getting used to. But they use data to determine who people want to see. They use data. So you have to really work on building your numbers up, your Facebook numbers, your Twitter, your Instagram.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, it's hard work, and a lot of times, you know, people don't, we don't have the time. The kids got to sit up and punch on a phone all freaking day. You know, we got work to do. And,
right.
And, you know, it's, but data, I'm realizing, is so, so important.
Wow.
And, you know, when I get a chance to do a show, you know, with my girls, which from time to time has included Marina, she's had invitations from time to time.
Mm-hmm.
And they say, wow, we had no idea you guys were going to be this good. I'm like, well, we don't get the shots that we feel like we deserve because we don't have a whole lot of data. But, you know, I'm just working on that. Live is what I love to do, and I'm determined to, you know, get around to every major city, all the people that keep sending messages on Facebook like, can you guys come here, come to D.C.? We've had a few from Philly. The Bronx is on, you know, on alert. Chicago. Man, it's going to happen one way or another, but it's not happening fast enough for me.
Well, you know what you could do? This is a little advice from your man E over here. You have a lot of interns, you know, from colleges that it's free. Reach out to the colleges and let them do their job. And they work wonders. These millennials work wonders. They definitely get your numbers up, and they'll definitely get you in front of people again.
Thank you, Eric. I'm going to take those
advice and set that down.
Yeah. Now, that's some great advice.
But definitely, these colleges is... Sorry about it. Go ahead.
Yeah. No, I'm just talking, but I just thought about the value of old school music. It's like it takes you to a place that you usually remember something wonderful in your life.
Mm.
And that is just so cool. Like, it takes you places. I think about when I used to listen to Michael Jackson and Stevie Wonder when he was doing, you know, when I was like in high school. And when I hear those early records or the Supremes, I think about, you know, I'm older watching Ed Sullivan show, and how excited I used to be. And Luther Vandross used to talk about when he was punished, his mother wouldn't let him watch Ed Sullivan. Because that's the only place you could see people.
Mm-hmm.
But the music takes you to a place in time that means something in your heart, and that's just beautiful.
No, we definitely need that. That's why, you know, this radio station here, the lane is classic hip-hop and R&B, because we wanted to give the fans and the listeners a chance to reminisce. Right now in this world, we're surrounded by nothing but hatred and bad news. So yeah. Somebody has to step up front and give them something that they can say, you know what, when Klymaxx was out and I Miss You was out, I met your dad or I met your mom, something that will click to make someone say, I remember. Because every song doesn't have to be reflect on a bad time. It can reflect on a great time.
Right. A simpler place in time, as Gladys says.
So, you know, that's what we want to do.
Time travel, and I love it. That's awesome. Yeah. Time travel, because it gives you the feelings that you had back then. You're like, oh wow.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
I'm not gonna tell you how many times I got in trouble if I Miss You, because that's a whole nother show, and I'm interviewing y'all. You're not interviewing me, so I'm gonna leave that one alone. But like I told you, I was in Job Corps when that song was bubbling, and yeah, that's all I'm gonna say.
Hey, well, we're happy to be a part. Yeah.
No.
Oh, definitely, definitely. And then I'm going to throw something else at you ladies, too. Now, you said, you know, never say never. So, never say never that y'all might end up coming to PA. Never say never.
Hey, okay. I'm with her. I never say never about anything. The older I get, the more I learn. I just really don't know nothing about a lot of stuff.
No, we'll talk behind the scenes. I'm going to have Joe link you up with me behind the scenes, and I think we could do some things. And I think that you guys would definitely be embraced, because right now is what I'm seeing is there's more old school shows than new school shows now.
Somebody was saying that in part because you don't get shot and beat up at.
That's right. It's safe.
Safer.
It's like a baseball game. Safe.
Yes.
And no one's asking for all this security and all that, because people want to go out. Joyce and Lorena, people want to go out and they want to chill, especially in our the late 30s going up. Ain't nobody got time for that thugging and bugging. They want to
know what's funny. I noticed on my data that for me, my second core fan group is men 35 to 45. That's my second biggest demo. That trips me out.
Because,
but it's beautiful because we just want to have fun.
And that's all everybody wants. You know, we have gotten mature. You know, we have kids. We have grandchildren. Nobody want to go out no more and either go upside somebody's head or have somebody go upside your head. They want to take their woman out, have a good time, laugh, reminisce, and go home.
Yeah. Yeah. That was the 20s are gone. And so are many of the stuck on stupid moments that we had, because I had my share. And you're supposed to be stupid in your 20s.
But I got to correct you on that. Hold on.
Okay.
When we was coming up, yes, we've done stupid stuff. But we also had a lot of fun. Like, we can go to parties.
Oh, yeah.
You know, we dressed. Like, the things that we were into, these kids, we didn't have a Nintendo and all that other crazy stuff. We had Atari coming up, but it still didn't hold us captive in the house.
It was certainly different because we were more social and connected to the earth and people.
Mm.
It's like we weren't connected to machines. We're like automatons stuck to a machine all day. Now, I completely get what you're saying. I'm just saying when you're younger, you have a license to try many things and just be stupid. And as you age, you get a little more mature and you start to cut some of those things out. But listen, we had fun. It's like I spent 3 years trying all kinds of crazy drugs. I almost died twice.
Mm.
I'm so glad I'm here. I'm so glad I stopped.
Amen.
I had fun along the way. Like, you know, like, and, you know, I try to have empathy for young people being stupid because you got to go through your process. And hopefully you can mature and have some guidance and come out of it. So I'm just grateful. So.
And we praying for the young folks. We're definitely praying. And like I said, again, I'm sorry to keep repeating myself, but it's an honor and a pleasure to have you ladies on, because I always when I got into radio, I said, somebody asked me, well, what's your goal? Like, how are you going to do this? I said, I want them to tell their story. I don't want somebody else to tell their story. So I want to be the radio version of Unsung.
I love it.
And I want to give a shout out to a good friend of mine, because he is one of the narrators from Unsung. I'm talking about Tyrone DuBois. I want to shout him out. Great mentor.
Shout out to Tyrone.
He is the R&B historian. And, you know, I told him I was interviewing you guys, and he gave me the history. He off the head, like a rapper. Oh, Klymaxx. They charted at blah, blah, blah. I was like, wow. I'm saying to myself, how the hell does he do this?
Wow.
So much data in his head about music and groups. Wow.
Some people are good, just like LeBron with his photographic memory, can recount the last 10 plays of a game 2 years ago. So people just have the gift. That's amazing.
They have the gift. So one of the young ladies on the line right now, I'm just going to give y'all a hint, Joyce. She got a hot new joint with another icon that had the ladies going all crazy. I'm talking about Mr. Howard Hewitt. How did that all come about?
That's my boo. You know what's funny? Ever since, before I ever got in the group, when I was hanging out with George and the Solar Galaxy of Stars would come to town with Lakeside, Dynasty, The Whispers, and Shalimar, I would be on the loading dock. But Howard was always nice to me. When I first moved to L.A. and joined the group, we didn't have any hits. I'd be like, Howard, I wrote this song. I want you to come sing it. He would just come and sing songs I wrote in the studio.
Wow.
He's just always been like a brother to me. And so I think maybe 3 years ago, he sent me a Valentine or something. And I called him. I said, thank you for remembering the senior, the older ladies too, Howard. He just started laughing. I said, I want you to come. And that's what I told him. I said, I want you to come and sing this song with me. It took about a year, but eventually he did. He's just like, okay, Joyce, I'll be there next week. What do you want to do? He's just cool. He's like, okay, see you next time. And then he's out.
Well, tell him he's on my bucket list too, because I would love to interview. I told Joe, I said, I need to talk to Howard Hewitt. Got to get him on the show too, because I want to hear his story.
I will certainly send him a text about that.
Definitely want to hear his story.
He's a very, very gracious dude. He's a very gracious gentleman. And Arena, I mean, Howard was kind to everybody. I mean, I'm talking about me, but he loves all of us, right?
Oh, yeah. He's the big bro, the homie, the cry-on-the-shoulder guy. He's whatever you need him to be. And that's Howard for sure.
With the legendary voice, ladies and gentlemen, we talk about Mr. Howard Hewitt from the group Shalimar. For those of y'all that don't know, Google that. Just saying.
And he still got his falsetto, too.
Wow.
He's me out. I'm like, dude,
yeah.
I love it.
Wow.
Yeah.
Reminisce. So I got a great question for you guys now. And we're going to remove Howard now because it involves a duet. So we're going to remove him. We can't use him.
Okay.
But if you had the opportunity to do a duet with two women singers and two male singers, who would it be? Outside of Howard Hewitt.
Lorena, you go first. I know one of mine immediately. You go first.
Mine would be Chaka Khan, of course.
Okay.
Yeah, she's my favorite. And another female. I would like to. Let me go to the guy, because I can't think of another female. When I say Jocka, that's just like the end of it.
Okay.
But my guy, I would love to do a throwback old school duet with Bo Watson from Midnight Star. I love his voice.
Aww. Wow.
Yes.
You can label me. You can do that now. Just pick up the phone. You can do that now, kitty.
Yeah, like, come on, Bo. Come on over. And then I would love to sing my other favorite is Peebo Bryson.
Wow. Okay.
That's doable too. He's down the street.
Yes, he is.
Yeah, call Regina.
Say, Regina, we need, Bo Watson and Peebo Bryson. And Chaka, I can't think of somebody other than somebody I've already sang a duet with. If I had a chance, it would just be Chaka.
Okay.
Yeah.
All right, Joyce, it's your turn.
My first choice straight up is Drake. Period. I love Drake. I like his rapping. I like his singing. I like his thought process. I like his flow. I like the tone and texture of his voice.
Wow.
He's number one. Absolutely. He's number one. Number two is actually a young man that nobody knows. His name is Zion Birdsong. You'll know him at some point. He's a 30-something-year-old acoustic guitar player who writes and sings and raps and does incredible things. And actually, I am having the opportunity to work with him. We're recording some stuff together now. He's
okay.
Amazing. And the name will come back. Women, number one. I'm just like all over the place. Celine Dion.
Wow.
She is just my favorite. I love her. I love her. I saw her show in Vegas, and I was just sitting there crying. It was just so beautiful. And I like 1,000 other people, so, anybody who I could have the honor to sing with, I'll sing with. I'll be happy to do it, you know. I can't pick another individual woman out, but those are mine.
All right, I get to go now.
Yeah.
I would like to have Joyce and Lorena do a duet with, this is a group, with Guy.
With
Guy, Aaron Hall, Damian Hall, Teddy Riley.
Can I just tell you a quick Teddy story?
Let's go.
I met Teddy in March. We had a show in Oklahoma City. Teddy comes into the dressing room and introduces himself to me like I don't know who he is. I'm like, oh my God, I can't believe it. Hi, I'm Teddy Riley. And he said he used to have a group called Klymaxx. And when we came out, he had to change the name of his group. I was like, what? It is so, he is
oh my goodness,
personable dude. Yes, I love him. And he came, he's like, I'm coming back early for y'all's show. He came and he was like, I can't believe they had so-and-so coming on after y'all. I won't say who, but he was like, he's just a wonderful dude. And he's so brilliant and soft-spoken and sweet. Yeah.
Yes, he is a sweet guy.
And I had to throw my boys in it because I am connected to Damian Hall. He is also one of the co-owners of the radio station.
So, all right, thank you for letting us come on in.
Oh, definitely.
Yes, thank you, Damian.
Hey, yeah.
So I would definitely saw that. I think that y'all can, some great magic could come out of that one, especially with Teddy on the production.
Actually, there's another producer who knows Teddy, who actually is reaching out to him about something like that. That's interesting. But yeah, Teddy, it's like older artists still can create great music.
Mm-hmm.
It's just that, I guess, contemporary radio, they'll play old music by older artists, but anything new is from somebody younger all the time. I feel like they're forcing it down my throat, so I just tune out.
No, that's why you gotta listen. That's why you gotta listen to WWRN AM 1620, because we keep the legends alive.
So your
new music will be played over here. So don't worry about what they won't do for you. Worry about what we'll do for you over here.
Oh, yeah. Okay. I just want to get in front of some live audiences. I feel like the more people that see whoever you are as an artist, the more people that see you display your art, the more people connect to you. And that's where the value is.
Well, I'm a rock you and Lorena right now. I'm a rock y'all. And another thing that we got working for us, we got our own cable channel too.
That's a beautiful thing.
Come on, cable.
So we need to, that's why I said we need to talk behind the scenes, because we can get you in front of some people now. Come on.
That's a beautiful thing.
Because that's the goal. Like I said, that is our goal. We have a network called Rewind, which is going to mix some of the new with the old. And it's Rewind with two E's, not one.
Okay.
Rewind.
I like that.
Okay.
So my passion is music. I love music, everything about music. And I just said I want to build a platform to let the fans know you guys are still moving, you guys are still doing things, because a lot of times they don't know. They don't know.
Right. Yeah.
So I want to make it easier for them. True. With y'all help, I want to make it easier for them. So we got to get y'all in Delaware something in front of a camera, so that way you guys can let people know we're live and we're doing shows. Come see us. Request us.
They are genuine.
It's like, where have you been?
We heard. We don't want y'all to hear. We want y'all to see.
Experience.
And please, before we let you ladies go, please let them know. Social media, we need that. Where to find you, everything. Website, I need it all. Give it to them.
Well, I'll start with Instagram. I'm just Joyce Irby. My group that I perform with is Klymaxx, is everywhere at Klymaxx FM, like FM radio. Mm-hmm. It really stands for Femme Mafia, which is women empowering each other and not tearing each other down. So it's at Klymaxx FM, Facebook, Instagram, wherever. And I'm, yeah, Facebook, Instagram, Joyce Irby. If you go on Facebook, just put my name in and I just call it be popping up, you know. My personal page, my artist page, whatever. I did my first Facebook Live on my personal page today telling people, I just need you to listen to music and stop sending me these whack personal messages. So I got great response, so thank you, everybody.
Well, I'm following you now on Instagram. I'm waiting for Lorena, and then I'm going to follow her.
And mine is Lorena Lungs, L-U-N-G-S, on Instagram. And Facebook is Lorena Stewart or Lorena Lungs Stewart. Either one, you can find me there. I'm not too much of a Twitter, but I do have a Twitter page. Mm-hmm. It's called Klymaxx Diva Lungs. But other than that, you can really, I'm on Instagram more.
All right, well, I just requested
yeah,
you.
I just followed you back.
Okay, I got you. And I just requested Lorena Lungs, the E.Jones Show.
Yes.
Please let me in. Please.
I'm going to let you.
Yeah.
Thank you.
And I'll also do Klymaxx FM.
And that's on, I got that on Facebook. Is that
Instagram? Yeah, that's on everywhere. Okay.
Okay, Klymaxx. FM. All right, let me do that one. So I'm all in.
We're all in.
And I'm on my phone, and it's not letting me do anything right now because I'm on the phone.
Okay, no problem.
While I'm driving. Yes, but I will be adding you as soon as I am immobile.
No problem. I'm following Klymaxx FM also, too. I'm here. I got you guys, and whatever you guys post or whatever, you know, I definitely, any promoters that I know, I will definitely point them in your direction. But I got a little idea. Like I said, I have Joe link us up together that definitely would work for you guys. And
Mr. Never Stop.
That's right. Never Stop. Shout out to my man, Joe Mason. Yo, E, I got you. I got you. I'm about to call Joyce right now. I'm going to give her the call-in number. She gonna call in at 7 o'clock. I called her yesterday.
He's so cute. I'm going to call Joe as soon as we get off the phone.
Yeah, I had a little eye issue yesterday. He said, hold on, E. Stay by your phone. I said, Joe, I ain't going nowhere. My eye hurt. Just sit by your phone real quick. I'm going to call Joyce. She going to call Lorena, she gonna find out if they can do this tomorrow. I said, Joe, I just told you, I'm sitting in my house with a pair of shades on. My eye hurts.
He was like, how is your eye now, though?
Better. It's definitely better.
Okay. Yeah, you gotta watch that, man. You gotta just take care of it. Take care of it.
Well, she said that something flew in my eye. I thought it was pink eye, but she said something flew, a bug flew in my eye. And the night, Sunday night, my wife must have washed it out because I got up at 2:30 in the morning. I was like, oh, my eye is killing me. And the light from the TV was burning my eye. I went into the bathroom. I was like, can I just turn the light out and go in the dark? And she was like, just cover your eyes. So she rinsed it out, but I still had to go to the doctor Monday because it was irritated. And I'm sitting there looking at this lady. Oh. She was like, I'm going to put yellow dye in your eye. I was like, oh, what is she going to do to me?
Oh, my goodness.
So she put a number in my eye first. Then she went in there with a swab and got up under my eyelids. And I was like, oh, wow, this is crazy.
Then she numbed it first, boy.
Yeah, she numbed it first. And then she put the yellow dye in it just to see if everything was correct. And then so I spent like yesterday oozing yellow dye coming down the side of my face. So I was like, I can't go outside like this. So I just stayed in. But I'm doing better.
Well, that's good to know.
And plus, I told you, I said, I gotta have this interview. So I said, I'm going to make it work. And today, I got up. Everything was okay. I was blessed to have you two queens on the line, you iconic, legendary queens on the line. We had a great conversation. We touched on a lot of stuff. And I'm going to do my part and make sure that people know and make sure you guys know that we still love you and we miss you.
Well, we definitely grateful. Love you for having us. We're very grateful and appreciative.
Yes.
And it's all...
Even for the ones who aren't on the phone, they're all grateful to be just remembered, just to have our journey remembered. Everybody's grateful for that.
Well, you're always going to be remembered here. And whatever you guys got going on, reach out to Joe, say, yo, E, put me in play with E again. And you're always welcome to come on the show to say hi, to come on and tell a story, to come on and tell us where you're performing at. Our door's open for you.
Thank you so much.
And you ladies have a blessed evening. And please, let's set up a meeting with Joe, because I definitely feel like I can give y'all a hand. I got something brewing, but I don't want to put it out in the universe. And then people tell me, so when that's going to happen then? We don't need all that yet.
Well, you know, Joe will be on top of everything.
Oh, definitely, definitely. Joe has been a very big supporter of me and my sister doing this radio show. He was like, you on 80-plus stations, independent. How you do that? Because I don't want no one telling me what I can't play. I don't want to be programmed.
Maybe you'll start something new and free us all.
Oh, well, I plan to free us all, and we're going to do what we got to do. Like I said, we got the cable channel launched now. It's so much that I want to do to make sure, like I said again, that people know that groups like Klymaxx, Guy, everybody, they're still here. They're still doing shows, and they're real people. You can approach them and talk to them, because a lot of times somebody see a group like you guys, I'm like, I ain't talking to them because they might be mean. Because they assume.
Oh, no. Right.
So my job is to... You, lovely ladies, y'all. Lovely ladies. And we had a meeting in the ladies' room, and I'm the only dude in there. I'm happy.
Hey, it's all good. And we've enjoyed it. And just thank you. Thank you for the time. Thank you for sharing your audience with us. And we thank you for blessing our evening.
Anytime.
Thank you.
You queens have a great night and the rest of the great week.
Thank you as well.
Take care.
All right. Thank you so much.
Bye bye.
Appreciate you.
Anytime. Bye bye.
Bye.
All right, Eric. Bye.
Yes, indeed. That was the legendary group Klymaxx. Joyce, Irby, Lorena joined us. Great conversation. If y'all are looking to book the iconic legendary group Klymaxx, go to Klymaxx FM on Instagram or go to www.klymaxxfm.com. Support this group, y'all. Legends, icons, female band, great music on top of that. And it was an honor and a pleasure to have them come on the show and bless us. Definitely an honor. Man, I feel lucky. I can't even front on you. I definitely feel lucky because think about it. Klymaxx. I used to watch the video on Video Music Box. Now I had a chance to talk to him. It's dope. Real dope. I'm going to bless y'all with meeting in the ladies' room. I'm going to put on the men pause because it's going to be my dedication to you guys from Klymaxx. And, it's your man, E.Jones, man. I'm here. Hopefully, you guys enjoyed the show. I definitely enjoyed the show. I definitely enjoyed the interview. And you never know, man. We're going to keep this thing going. We'll keep it going.
You are now tuned in to the E.Jones Show.
Featuring Sharonda
and Thalys. DJ Mark NYC.
doing. Girl, he's doing like nobody else can. You wanna be sure your best gon' powder your nose, 'cause you wanna look good when you step on the floor.
Blue leather suit. My nails were done and my hair was fierce. feel.
I was riding in a Cooper's limousine.
Don't you want to ride? I was at home feeling sleazy.
Jones Show.
E.Jones Show.
E.Jones Show.
E.Jones Show.